So who are some of your influences? Well, if not Menudo?
The Stooges, you know, Rolling Stones, you know. But we have a lot of fucking, like, influence. Like, I think, like, fucking Menudo too, you know. Like, yeah. Man, we grew up listening to Menudo when we were kids, you know.
On this tour, we've been listening to, like, trashy disco stuff. It's like Patrick Hernandez going to be alive, you know, that song. Yeah. I mean, we dig this stuff. It's catchy, it's cute or whatever. It's goofy, because we're goofy too.
We love trashy shit with good melodies. You
like comedy too, you know. I noticed. Funny.
That's what I noticed about your music. It really was catchy. It was, you know, something that people of all ages, I think, could enjoy. Tell me about,
it's all about the hooks, you know.
Yeah, well, how about singing in Spanish?
Man, it's like
how we primarily think.
Like I told you before, it's like we eat, we go to sleep, we live our regular life thinking in Spanish. So what the fuck am I gonna sing in English? You know, it's like I talk.
You find better rhythms instead of Puerto Rican.
Nah, but it's like, you know, it's like you talk of what you know, you know what I mean?
It becomes your thing, our thing, you know, the way we, you know, sing our you know, our Puerto Rican slang or whatever, you know. But in a kind of like a, I guess, like, music is universal, so it's like a universal phonetic, you know, like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's like when we started, like, you know, playing music, we didn't know English, you know what I mean? When we were kids, like, we were listening to all these, like, songs, you know, and we always see it's like,
yeah, it sounded like that to us.
It sounds to us. And when you grew up older, you know, we just take, like, the phonetics of English songs, you know what I mean? It's like, and we just, like, when we make music, you know, it's like, we do like phonetics. We don't like write the lyrics and we do all the shit. Like we go, wah, 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 and then we write the lyrics in Spanish, you know what I mean?
I've seen documentaries of Keith Richards coming up with Salt of the Earth, and he doesn't have the lyrics. Like,
it's all about phonetics, you know what I mean?
It's like, the melody. You come up with the melody.
But it has to be in Spanish because we think in Spanish. We don't think in English, you know? Mm. So that's the basic of everything. And I think if we sing in English, it would be fake, you know? Because we don't fucking think. Of course, we don't fucking think in English, man.
I think I'm bilingual, sir. Speak for yourself.
Oh, I don't fucking think in English, you know what I mean?
It's like, I live in America.
Me too, but it's like when you're in your house, you don't fucking think in English. I think in Spanish.
What about the crowds? Is there any difference in the crowds when it comes to what language they happen to speak? I'm sure you played, well, obviously, English and Spanish language crowds. What about other languages? Have you been?
Man, it's like we are playing in Europe. It's like, it's the same shit. It's like, I think music is a universal language, you know? So it's like, I told you before, like when we were kids and we didn't know English and we listened to all these melodies, it's all about the melody.
Crowds, you mean?
You know? Like, no, it's like when we were kids and we were listening to music and we didn't know English, it's like, you listen to the melody, it's all about that. And I think that's what happened, like, when we play in Europe or when we play in the States. It's all about energy and melody.
Thank you.
cute.
So you guys are playing Mexicali tomorrow night, right?
Yeah. Tomorrow night, yeah.
You expect different kind of crowd, different kind of vibe, different kind of feedback?
Well, it is more relatable when they know the lyrics, of course, you know. But most people are, like, in the Spanish-speaking countries, usually, like, the people we play to, they usually know both English. I don't know. So they get it. Like, it's kind of the same, but it's a bit more relatable in the language thing with the song. But there's mm-hmm. not really any difference. Like, it's still rock and roll. It's still music. You know, it's still a great, fun time.
Rock and roll is all about energy. You know what I mean?
The difference would be, they're different cultures.
The last time you guys passed through the area was in 2007?
That was the first time.
Okay.
Yeah, last time that we were in Mexicali was like 2011, and we played with One City Road.
Okay.
That's a good friend. That's our last show in Mexicali. That's like, but I live now in Mexico City. I have been living there for 1 year and 4 months, and we play all the time, like in Mexico. It's like, so it's like, it's like an exchange of music. You know what I mean? It's like even it's like when like you feel it more when you play like in border cities, like you when you play Mexicali, you play Tijuana,
yeah,
or Juarez, like you feel more that
Laredo,
yeah, you feel more that, you know, like people from Mexico are more adapted to what's happening in the States. It's more than when you play in Mexico City or you play in Guadalajara, they're more on the Spanish, you know,
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
But like when you're like on the cross border, like people, because it's like a staff, like you have all these people that work every day in, when you go to, you know, to El Paso, you have Juarez, and you have people goes to Juarez every day to work in El Paso, like in Calex, in Mexicali,
yeah.
They go to a center to work every day. So I think it's like a community of people, you know. Thank you.